Hi, I'm Matt Willis with today's COVID-19 response update. There's been a lot of interest in contact tracing and what that exactly means. Contact tracing can save lives by helping us diagnose patients earlier and reducing the chance that they'll spread the virus to others. Here's how it works. COVID-19 is diagnosed through a laboratory test. Every laboratory that tests in Marin reports to us right away every positive result with the contact information for the case. So let's say this is a case of COVID-19. One of our public health nurses or one of our other contact tracers will reach out to that person with two objectives. First, to make sure that they're able to successfully isolate, to pull them out of their environment to make sure that there are others that might be around them may not be further exposed. And then also to determine who around them might have had close contact, their circle of exposure. And that's defined as people who have had limited distance over a certain duration of time with that person. Generally, everyone in the household is defined as a close contact, and people who might have shared confined workspace with them. Those individuals are also contacted to make sure that they are quarantined, and we will arrange testing for those individuals who had close contact. So let's say one of those people, after testing, is diagnosed with COVID-19. That person then becomes our next case, and the process begins again. Our contact investigator will reach out to that person to do the interview to determine who their close contacts were. And they will be quarantined. And let's say one of those individuals was also diagnosed. They become our next case. And the process begins again. And so you can see how over time, as these chains of transmission grow, what may be one case might become many more. And there's a lot more work to do to contact trace all of those individuals who are either cases or exposed to them. One of the reasons this is so important is if we think about it, here's one case. If that one case infects just two people, that would be an R-naught. R-naught is the term that we use to apply to the number of people that are infected by any one case. So an R-naught of two would mean one case infects two. The R-naught for COVID-19 can be anywhere between 2 and 6 if we don't do anything, right? Unless we're really on our game to make sure that each person who's infected isn't infecting others, we could see multiple cases from every single case. So an R-naught of 2 would look like this over time. 1 case to 2 to 4 to 8 over a period of maybe 10 days. So the reason why contact tracing is so important and so why it's so important for us to achieve our goal of reaching every single case within 24 hours of diagnosis to isolate them is that we want to cut it off here to interrupt that possibility that one case could lead to, in sum, of 15 total cases here. So a truly successful contact tracing process includes the ability to isolate cases as soon as possible to interrupt transmission. And this requires housing for people, right, who live in very close quarters, workers' protections, and even supplemental income for those who can't afford to step away from work even for a few days. It also requires the ability to quarantine and test those who have been exposed. And this is why we're investing so much in growing our contact tracing team from 15 to 50 in Marin County over the next few weeks to make sure we have the workforce to achieve our goal of reaching 90% of people within 24 hours of diagnosis to make sure they're successfully isolated so that we can nip these chains of transmission in the bud. And this is why it's so important for all of us to do what we can to limit the risk of infection when we're out and about together, because the likelihood that a case will become another 1 or 2 or 4 or 8 is largely up to us by practicing social distancing and covering our face and washing our hands. So our army of disease detectives is growing, and I hope you'll have a better sense of the good work that they'll be doing. Thank you, and stay healthy.